Now, as a legendary comedian and a national treasure...
We're packed with national treasures this morning, aren't we?
The second national treasure, yeah. Well, three, actually. Sir Lenny Henry has always brought the laughs, but in a one-off documentary, we're going to see a very different side to him, as Lenny returns to his family's roots in the Caribbean.
To mark the relationship between Her Majesty the Queen and the Commonwealth, Lenny Henry, the Commonwealth kid, examines that special relationship between Britain and the Commonwealth, and it's 2.3 billion people. And he joins us now. Very good morning to you.
Morning.
And as you were saying, not many of us really are taught about it, learn about it, and yet it is so significant.
It's huge, yeah.
Especially, presumably, for, you know, for many other countries. So when you went back to Jamaica and talked to people there, what did they make of it?
Well, interestingly, if you said, you know, if I say Great Britain to you, what does that mean to you? And there'd be this kind of... The Queen, or tea, but they didn't reel off figures about the Commonwealth or talk about Commonwealth countries. Nobody said there are 53 countries in the Commonwealth, and Gambia recently rejoined. They didn't have any facts to hand. They didn't know what it was for. You know, Confederation of Trade and Business. They didn't talk about that stuff at all. They just basically had this general idea about the Commonwealth Games, and I was interested in that. Why don't people know more about it? Let's find out a bit more about it. She was a subsistence farmer with my dad and used to grow things and take it to market, and it was a punishing, gruelling existence.
Is that why they left?
And she had to leave. She had to leave Jamaica in the 50s because there was nothing there. They were literally starving.
And literally starving?
Yeah, so that... Well, I'm exaggerating.
All right, OK, but...
But the point is, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the Commonwealth. Because I was born here. I was the first to be born in Britain. Mm-hmm. And so, for me, I'm celebrating the Commonwealth. It's, I exist because of the Commonwealth, and so let's celebrate it. But... and also, I'm a Knight of the Realm. You know, I was assaulted by an old lady with a sword. So...
A Knight of the British Empire.
So, yeah, so I kind of... I have a conflict about that because of its origins. But, you know, as you kind of explore this stuff, you find out that it means a lot to people.
Mm-hmm. There are moments in the documentary... where you're moved to tears. There are moments in the documentary where you can clearly see the history of Jamaica and slavery, plantations, weighing on your mind.
Yeah, it was like a big stone on my heart. But I went to a rum plantation where called the Hampden Estate, and I met this lady called Christelle, who is now the boss of this, recent boss of this rum plantation. And it's a reduced staff now, but they once had 400 slaves working there. So to walk up the steps to meet this lady and to look at this huge place and to see where all these people used to work, you kind of have these flashbacks and think, God, oh, was that me? Because these are my ancestors. I'm the descendant of slaves. Yeah. So to be in this place where this stuff used to happen is a shock. And you're constantly in a garden. I couldn't wait to get out of there,
And how long did slavery last in your family? Who were the last slaves in your ancestors?
Well, there's no... I mean, because I haven't been on Who Do You Think You Are, like you, Richard,
you don't
I've got no idea. There's been no detective work.